Hi all, welcome back to the Danalyser. In today's video, I'm going to share with you an awesome techniques in Google Sheets where you can combine data from multiple tabs into one single tab or file so that you can use it for Data Studio or other purpose. So if you have watched my previous video, you would know that I actually covered this exactly same function on how you can use it to do some data transformation so that you can achieve more advanced feature in Data Studio. In case you missed that video, I'm going to link that tutorial down below for you so that you can refer to it later after watching this tutorial. And for today, we're going to focus solely on how you can use query function to combine multiple data sets. So before we start, to give you some context, this data set is about inventory tracking in a warehouse. So in the first data set, we actually have all the inventory that has built up status, loose. And for the second tab, we have all the inventory that has built up status solid. We will just going to call them loose inventory and solid inventory. So as I mentioned before, we're going to get them into one single sheet. And the constraint here is actually in the first data set, we actually have 13 columns. And for the second one, you can see that we actually have more than that. So our challenge today is to first extract all the columns we need from loose inventory and solid inventory. And then we're going to filter them based on this specific condition that we need, which is the current location needs to be in B712 or B703 only. That's a bit more complicated, so we are going to do it step by step. So first of all, I'm going to just make a copy of this. So our first step here is actually to extract the columns highlighted in green into the third tab, which is the inventory tab. So here, let me just make this bigger. So I'm going to just key in the formula query. And for the query function, the first parameter is the dataset itself. So it's the raw dataset. So I'm going to grab that loose dataset. We're going to start from A2. We're not going to include row 1 because that's the field name. So I'm going to start from A2 up to the last column, which is N. So for N, I'm not going to indicate the number because I want it to grab the entire data set so that when we have more data added, it will get pulled automatically. So after we have that data range for the raw data set, we're going to enter comma and followed by the double quotes. Now we're going to select and put an asterisk. So this asterisk means we're going to select all. If you are familiar with SQL, asterisk actually means all. So we're going to grab all the columns from A up to N. So if I just show you this, you can see that we have the exact same data set imported to inventory. But now what we're going to do is we actually wanted a few columns only. So now I'm going to go back to that tab and select the column. So I need A, B, C, D, E, G, H, and M. A to E. So I need A, B, C, D, E, G, H, and E. Oh, M. Sorry, the last is M. So now I have everything here. And the next one, we're going to grab the data set for solid. So we can just repeat the same step as we just did. So temporarily, I'm going to just put it here, but later I'll show you how to combine them. So now the second step is to extract data from the solid tab. So same thing, we're going to just use query function. Just go up. Oops. Okay. Query function. And we're going to key in solid as the cell the sheet name. And then I'm going to grab from A to V. From A to V. So now we have all the data set. And now it's time for us to select the fields that we want. So I'm going to grab from A to E, L, M, and U. So select A, B, C, D, E. Sorry, I forgot. Which are the other ones? L, M, and U. Okay, so now we have all the data. Let me just freeze this column first. Oh, okay. I'm going to freeze this so that I can see the data. Okay, so this is because I have put the formula here. So just let me just move the formula to the other side so it won't throw us the error. So basically, I have this data set from loose and this data set from solid. So they both have the same columns and the location of the columns are all the same. So now the next step is actually filtering this data set from loose. I want to filter based on the current location when it's equals to B712 or B703. So now I'm going to modify the select statement in the formula. So in order for this query function to extract the data based on the criteria that we want, we can use where clause in this select statement. So you can just add where. And here I'm going to use the location. So here the location is actually the column M. So we can use M when M equals to B712 or M equals to B703. So here, this query will help us to evaluate row by row whether the column M equals to B712 or B703. So if it fulfills the condition that we want, then it's going to return us the value. And right after I hit enter, you won't see the current location that has value CTU. So now I'm just hit enter. And you can see that now this data set is being filtered accordingly. And now we are going to do the same thing for the second data set, which is for the solid inventories. So now just double click the cell and you can see the formula right away. So add the condition where the column, I think is the last column, which is U. So you are going to follow back these columns that you select and not the current location of this of the data. So where U equals to B703 or U equals to B712. So One thing that you may notice is that in this value, I'm using a single quote because I'm already using the double quotes for the formula. So if you're using double quotes, this would not work properly. So make sure you're using single quote for the values. So now you can see that the second data set is also filtered to B03 and 712 only. So now to combine both data sets, we are going to copy the formula from the second data set. So now I'm just going to copy this and come to the first one, A2, and use a, what is it called? Semicolon, and paste the second function over here. Right after that, if you hit enter, you'll probably get an error. So how do we fix this is to add a curly bracket around the formula. So I added this and this at the end and at the very beginning. So now you can see both data sets are beautifully appended together. And you can see that it's loose followed by solid inventory. So now in case you want to sort the data set based on some values here. So for example, maybe I want to sort them based on the stack number. So what I can do is to come to here and add another function for query. And then I can have another select function over here. So now I'm going to select all because now we have already pre-processed using the function previously to extract the columns that we want. So now all of the columns here are what we want. And then we can use Then we want to sort the column based on the stack number. So now I can use order by. And here I'm going to use column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you'll notice that instead of using the alphabet indicator, now I'm using column 6. So why I do this is because when you are using the curly brackets to define the data set, the header name is no longer the alphabet. It has become the numbering, which is you can call them as column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5, and column 6 by default. So here I'm using column 6, and you can see that it's always C capital letter and small letter OL followed by the numbering of the column's location. And here, if I didn't indicate the ascending or descending, it's always by default sorted by ascending. So now I'm going to just enter and show you that. Oops, what did I do wrong here? Okay, so just now I entered an additional curly brackets. So once I remove that, we can actually get the data set here. And you can see that now it's sorted based on the stack number. And if I change this to descending by adding this descending, DESC, the data set will be sorted accordingly. So this is what I want to cover in today's tutorial. Basically, you have learned about query and how you can use them to extract data. And you have also learned how you can combine different data sets using the semicolon. And lastly, You learn how to filter your data sets using the where condition. And also you have learned two methods on how to extract your column. One is by the alphabet and the second is by the order of the columns. So I hope that is useful for you. If you have any questions related to this query function, feel free to leave them below so that I can answer them in the next video. And see you next time. Bye bye.